Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're doing a video on the best performance modifications for the 3.0 EcoDiesel used in Dodge, Ram, and Jeep vehicles. There are two generations of the 3.0 EcoDiesel that were used in the US. That's the Gen 2 and the Gen 3. The Gen 2 lasted until about 2019, and then the Gen 3 was introduced in 2020 plus model years. The Gen 2s produced 240 horsepower and 420 torque, and the Gen 3s produced 260 horsepower and 480 feet-pound of torque. Now, when you take these two engines and put them on a dyno, the Gen 2 versions will typically dyno somewhere around 200 wheel horsepower, and the Gen 3s will dyno around the 220 wheel horsepower range. So now before we jump into the best performance modifications for these EcoDiesels, let's go ahead and address some power limits that are helpful to know before you go ahead and jump into modifications. First of all, the 3.0 EcoDiesel has cast iron rods and cast aluminum pistons, which generally speaking are not the greatest materials for high horsepower builds. With that being said, the internals on the 3.0 EcoDiesel are capable of handling about 400 wheel horsepower, which is what we've seen to be about the safe limit. Anything above that, and you're significantly increasing your risk of cracking a piston or bending a rod or causing some form of internal damage. 400 horsepower is about as far as we would recommend pushing these. Now, to get to those levels, you're gonna have to go ahead and upgrade the turbocharger as well as look into some other additional modifications. The stock turbo can handle about 325 wheel horsepower when you really push it. However, we would recommend if you're looking to make 300 plus, especially on a Gen 2 engine, that you go ahead and look at an upgraded turbo to get past those power levels, as the turbocharger is not going to be very reliable at 300 plus wheel horsepower, as it's really going to be pushing its upper limits. So that being said, since these cars dyno in the low 200s and the stock turbo caps out around 300s, you don't really have a whole lot of wiggle room between basic modifications and having to get a little bit more advanced and upgrade the turbocharger. Once you get into upgrading the turbo, there's a lot more considerations with respect to OEM style drop-in turbos to compound turbo setups. And then you start looking at more advanced modifications like fueling, potential oil cooler upgrades, intercooler upgrades, and things like that. Just given the cost of those upgrades, this video is going to focus on some of the more basic bolt-on modifications that can help you get towards that 300 wheel horsepower mark. The first modification, and hands down the best on our list, is engine tuning. A basic off-the-shelf tune can add about 50 wheel horsepower and 80 torque. Now, if you want to get into custom tuning and push things on a little bit more of an aggressive tune, you can get a little bit more out of it than that. But basic, just off-the-shelf tunes that come from someone like Banks Power or GDE will add about 50 wheel horsepower and 80 torque, making this the best power adder out of all of the modifications on our list. And this really is the first pillar of modifications to this vehicle. All of the other things that we're going to talk about on this best mod list either require tuning or are amplified through tuning. And so the first thing that we recommend doing is definitely tuning. Now, if you want to go get custom tuning, then I recommend getting all of these additional mods first and then getting your custom tuning done. But if you're sticking with something off the shelf just to add some decent power without getting too crazy into modifications, then this is the first thing that we would recommend. Alongside going with engine tuning, another thing that is a really great addition is transmission tuning. The factory transmission is only rated for about 500 torque. Once you throw a tune on it, you're going to be pushing up close to those levels or above it. And especially if you look at doing further modifications, you can pretty easily push your transmission past the level that it's rated for. Now, it will hold up okay, you know, above the 500 torque level, but getting transmission tuning is a great option to improve transmission reliability, transmission longevity, and allow the transmission to hold additional power without slipping, hard shifting, or running into any other transmission problems that you might when you start to overload it. A lot of companies out there sell transmission tuning alongside the engine tuning. It's a great add-on alongside any engine tuning options you look at. Now, the second modification on our list is an upgraded thermostat. The 3.0 EcoDiesel runs a bit hot, especially when towing, which does lead to a number of problems on this engine, such as oil cooler related problems and problems with the emission systems within the exhaust. One of the best things you can do to keep engine temperatures down is upgrade to a colder 190 degree Fahrenheit thermostat. And what this is gonna do is allow your engine to run approximately 20 degrees colder than it would stock. Now this is important because once we add a tune on it, tunes predominantly make additional power by increasing the amount of boost that the turbo is producing. As a turbo produces more boost, it creates additional heat and leads to hotter exhaust gas temperatures. Reducing engine temperatures with a colder thermostat is hands down one of the best things you can do from a reliability standpoint for the 3.0 EcoDiesel when you're tuned. Next on our list is a downpipe. The downpipe is the first component of the exhaust system. It bolts up directly to the turbocharger and connects the turbocharger to the emissions related components of the exhaust system, like the DPF as well as the SCR system. Now, the downpipe on the 3.0 EcoDiesel is slightly restrictive. It does restrict exhaust gas flow, which leads to an increase in back pressure within the exhaust system. And this back pressure acts as a force against the turbocharger and essentially makes it harder for the turbocharger to spool. By upgrading the downpipe, what we do is give the engine a more freer flowing exhaust, which reduces the amount of pressure against the turbocharger, allowing it to spin more freely, which therefore increases the turbocharger's efficiency and leads to some decent power gains. A downpipe is gonna be the second best thing for power gains on the 3.0 EcoDiesel outside of tuning. Adding this to your engine will add usually over 10 wheel horsepower and over 10 wheel torque as well. And it is a great thing to do to improve reliability of your factory turbocharger when your turbo is tuned and running above stock boost levels. Reducing back pressure within the downpipe is the most important component just because of its proximity to the turbo, and so it's going to have the greatest effect on turbocharger efficiency. However, with that being said, there are a couple of other exhaust-related upgrades that could be worth it depending on your budget and what you're looking to do to your truck or Jeep. Your two options here are either running an emissions back exhaust system. This keeps all of your factory emissions equipment intact. It will help reduce back pressure within the exhaust system a little bit and give you a more free-flowing exhaust. However, because it sits after the emissions equipment, it generally won't do that much for performance or that much for back pressure reduction, but it still will add a little bit of horsepower and help lower EGTs a decent bit if it's something that you have in the budget. One of the biggest benefits of an exhaust system is obviously the sound. And so if you want a deeper sounding or louder truck or Jeep, then this is a modification to look for that. However, if you purely care about performance and engine reliability when modified, the best thing to do is to delete your emissions equipment. However, that really is only allowed for race vehicles as it makes your car illegal. It won't pass emissions tests. Generally, that's something that we don't necessarily recommend unless you really are trying to push the limits of this engine and looking to upgrade the turbocharger. Just upgrading the downpipe should provide enough benefit to the turbocharger to not need to mess with any of the emissions equipment, and it doesn't give you the headache of having to deal with having an illegal truck. But with that being said, if you do choose to delete it, that is perhaps one of the best exhaust-related modifications that you can make, as it will completely remove any of the restriction that's caused by all of the filters and all of that equipment that's within the exhaust system. So that covers it on our best modifications. When we break it down, there's really four things on our list here. It's tuning, which is the best performance-related modification. It'll add the most horsepower, it'll add the most torque, and it's probably the easiest thing that you can do and the most worthwhile. The second thing was a thermostat, which is more so a reliability modification. Certainly recommend it, especially if you do a lot of towing. It'll keep your truck running cooler, which is always good for reliability and longevity. And then the third component is exhaust related items. A downpipe is what we would recommend. We think that that's the most important portion of the exhaust system to upgrade. But if you want to take things a little bit further, you can also replace the rest of the exhaust system, whether you choose to keep the emission system in place or remove those as well. I would say if you just want to get a little bit of additional power out of your truck, throw a tune on it, throw a thermostat on it, and I think you'd be pretty happy with the power gains that you're getting from there. If you want to maximize reliability as well as get a little bit of additional power out of it, then we recommend adding a downpipe. Whether you choose to do anything after the downpipe generally depends on whether you want more sound out of your truck or if you want to get rid of the emissions equipment, because there are a number of common problems on these trucks related to the DPF and SCR systems. That's if you want to take things a step further and make your truck even a bit more reliable, reduce more back pressure, and give yourself a healthier turbocharger. So that's what we have for basic bolt-on modifications. Like we mentioned, if you really want to push past that 300 wheel horsepower mark, then we highly suggest looking into turbocharger setups, but we're gonna go ahead and save that for another video, just since there's a lot more things to take into account once you start looking at that. That covers it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you appreciated this video, go ahead, click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for future content.